Hello everyone, it's your favorite engineer, and you may be probably wondering if there's any new to my anti-spy jammer project, so the voice jammer that jams all the microphones around you. And yes, there were some changes lately, and I wanted to thank you to Thiago from Brazil, who had changed a lot in terms of the hardware for this project. So we'll see that in a moment, but basically what I wanted to mention is that we are now using not only the Digispark, but we are also using another boards like RP2040, ESP32C3, and you can even launch on the old, but still a viable ESP8266. Okay, so what are the hardware changes that I'm mentioning? So basically we got rid of an audio amplifier, and instead we are using this MOSFET driver chip, which is DC4420, or it can be alternatively IXDI614PI, which is better. And this MOSFET driver, guess what? It drives the MOSFET IRF4115, and this MOSFET is connected to the set of transducers with the coils. Why the coils are needed? This is because we are building something that is called LC tank, so coil capacitor tank circuit, the resonant circuit. And if you go to the Wikipedia, you will see that there's a kind of circuit, resonant circuit, that can store and reuse the energy. So once we are driving it with the rectangular pulse, during the on phase, the coil will store the energy, and while the MOSFET is off, it will give back the energy to the capacitor. The capacitor means the transducer, because if you go to the vendor page and see the transducer datasheet, you can see that there's a lot of information, including the capacitance. So we can see that there's each transducer has a 2 nanofarad of capacity. That is why we have adjusted coils to this value. Depending on the number of transducers you are using, you need to use the LC tank calculator to adjust the number of coils. But the rule of thumb is on this diagram, so you can use 4.7 per each four transducers, or different values that will depend on the number of transducers you are using. Okay, so that is one thing. The second thing, which is not basically mentioned on this picture, is that I'm powering this circuit with two Li-ion batteries, which voltage is further increased by the additional module, which is XL6009. Which in turn gives me something around 18 volts. Why 18 volts? 18 volts is the limit for this chip. But if you are using IXDI614, it will give you possibility to power it even with 30 volts. But please be aware, once you exceed 100 volts on the transducer, you will break it. So you can see that there is a 120 even possible, but frankly speaking, I broke it even with the lower voltage, so please be aware of this, and please be cautious while applying so huge voltage. Okay, so what about the source code? The source code is basically the same, so we are now having these three possibilities of using different boards, RP2040, ESP32C3, and ESP8266. The only difference that the code has is maybe the pin numbers per each board. So you may want to adjust it once you go to these settings on the source code. You may want to adjust the SPI information. So the SPI library is the same, but there may be a different pin numbers for each board. So you need to consult your documentation and adjust it in proper way. So for this RP2040, it is like this, but it may be different for different board, and basically there's nothing more changed. We know that this source code works the way that we start swinging the frequency from 24 kHz up to 26 in some intervals. So we are doing something like FM type of modulation, but we are doing the cap on the FM part. So this looks like a kind of soul type of FM modulation. You will see that in the moment in practice, while I'll be showing the oscilloscope signal. Okay, so let's now go to see how the hardware looks like. Okay, now you can see how it looks like when mounted. We have four main parts. So we have a bucket with the Li-ion batteries. This is 18650 two times. They are giving something around 8 volts, which is further increased by this particular module, which is basically, let me show you, is back-to-back DC converter, which allows you to convert these 8 volts even to 30 volts. What I extra did to this, I attached some heatsink on this XL chip, so you can see it over here. However, it does not really heat up. That really depend on the coils that you are using and if they are fitting this resonant frequency. Now this is the variable resistor that you can use to adjust the voltage. So once it is increased, it is further attached to the main board. So we can see the main board that is done exactly according to the diagram that I was showing. So we have, in particular, we have 5 volt stabilizer. This diode, it is just only to prevent from reverse voltage polarity. So if I would, you know, made an error and connected it wrong way, so it would not get fried. So we have LM7805, the voltage stabilizer, which is powering this RP2040 board, which is further connected to the AD9833, the signal generator. And the signal generator, guess what? It is connected to this TC4420 chip, which is further connected to the MOSFET over the gate of the MOSFET. And this is connected at the end to this set of transducers. I told you that I broke them, so you can see that this one is broken. Also this one. See? This is happening once you connect to high voltage, and you can see that it is pretty easy to do so. So before you do any setup, final setup, please adjust the voltage on this board. So this is very important. And in the moment, I will show you how it will look like. So how the signal looks like and how the signal looks like over there on the MOSFET and how the signal will look like on the transducers itself. Okay, so please. Okay, now I disconnected the transducers. I just wanted to show you what would the voltage look like. So if the Li-ion voltage is magnified, increased by this board, this XL6009, as a result you can get something like this. So 70.5 volt. And this is basically almost the maximum that the TC4420 can handle. So please be aware that if you exceed 18 volts, it will break. Okay? Okay, now let's go further. I will show you the signal on the components. Okay, so how the signal looks like on the AD9033. It is a rectangular tape-off signal, which is swinging from 24 to 26 and back, as you can see. This goes to the input of the TC4420. You can see it over here. And then this TC4420 drives the MOSFET. And at the end, at the MOSFET, it is magnified. So first, because I'm driving this MOSFET driver with the higher voltage, you can see that we are getting 17.6, and that is almost the maximum of this chip.
So you cannot exceed this value if you are using TC4420. If you are using IXDI614, it can be even 30 volts, but then you will break the, you know, you will break this one. Okay, so how the signal looks like when those transducers are connected. That will be very interesting. Before I connect the power to this, I just wanted to show you that I'm using those coils I mentioned. So these are connected in parallel to the transducers. On the back of the transducers, there's one coil every five or four transducers. You can, you know, adjust it to the best effect. So that will require some experimentation. And okay, I will now attach the oscilloscope to show you what will be the voltage on it. Okay, I have my oscilloscope connected. You can see that probe is configured to have a voltage divider. So it will divide by 10 times. So whatever you see here means it is the voltage really is 10 times higher. I will now magnify a bit so we could see the screen exactly. And now let's switch on. You will hear some noise. I stop it just for you to hear my voice. Okay, so you can see that we see this peak that has been generated by the coil, and we can see the oscillations. So this part of this rectangular shape of it's something that is delivered from the MOSFET. Once the MOSFET is switched off, the coil will give back the energy, which happens as a big peak of the voltage. In particular, here we have 72 volts, so this is a lot. So please be aware that if you put too much, those will break, right? Okay, how it works in practice? Let me show you. And it's gone. Okay, that would be all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave me a like and subscribe my channel. And see you next time. Bye bye.